Hey guys, J-Man the Disonex here bringing episode 100 of Let's Play the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth. In the last episode, I believe we did a, I think it was a greed mode run. I don't remember which character. Might have been Kane or Maggie? Or no, we did a Lilith run. That's what it was, I believe. A Lilith run to, the Dark Room, maybe? I don't remember. It's been a little while. But, this time we're going to be doing something a little bit different. So, yeah, for the 100th episode, I wanted to do a video on the BASE MENT seed. So if we get, when you're picking a character here, you can hit tab, or it's like a certain button on the control, but you need a keyboard to type them, so I'm just using keyboard for right now. And, you can type in, so we're gonna start out here with the seed that I want. So if you type in BASE MENT, it says found Easter egg, this is new in Afterbirth. So now if you hit Q, it now brings up a list of every Easter egg that you have unlocked. So, you could disable and enable any of the special seeds that you want. So you can now use any combination. Well, not any combination. There's a couple overlap. But you can now do different combinations of special seeds and have all of the effects stack. So right now I'm going to have a time lapse of me putting in all of the different codes. And yeah, I will see you guys when I'm done with that. Okay, so now that we have all those in, I believe that this is every code in the game. There's like 50, upwards of 50, I believe, if I recall correctly. But some of these even I don't entirely remember what they do, I'll be honest. But the main one that we're going for this time is, of course, the Infinite Basements one. The ones with the little, like, trophy with the circle through it, that means that if you have those seeds enabled, you can't unlock things and stuff like that. But some of these do make the game harder, and those ones, of course, you can keep enabled. Like right here, 12 heart damage, so that means that basically whenever you get hit, you just die instantly. Some of the interesting ones, don't stop moving, you take damage if you ever stop moving for a second. Reverse controlled, axe line controlled, you can camouflage stuff. Some minor aesthetic changes, like the blank is going to make your face completely blank, so we'll go ahead and turn that one on. And Christmas, it's not Christmas, never mind. Glowing Tears is kind of fun, we'll go for that. Extra Gore, that's fun. Champion Enemies, it's a basement seed, so obviously me losing isn't really much of a possibility. We'll go Champion Enemies, sure. I want to make this a little more interesting. Movement Tempo, I don't know if I want any of these other ones on. Let me do a quick run through again. Pickups, Timeout, Tricky Pickups. Pacifism, of course, is one of the more significant ones. You can't kill anything. You have to just wait for the doors to open by timing them out. Let's see. Dog mode, that's God mode. If you have that enabled, you can't lose, basically. So I don't necessarily want. Yeah, I think this is an okay set, especially since I don't remember, like I said, what a lot of these do, actually. Even though I could have sworn I entered all of the codes at some time recently, like on another save, but I don't even recognize a lot of these. Yeah, okay, this seems alright. We'll stick with this for now. Yes. Confirm. And of course we're going to go with Isaac, but I would like to have my controller. I just realized that. Oh no, I can just switch over. Okay. Yeah, we'll go hard mode, sure. And of course we'll go Isaac. Yeah, that seems good. Let's go for it. yeah, as you can see, I don't have a face anymore, so that's a very minor one there. What else did I even enable? Oh, right, every enemy is going to be a champion, I believe that can be. Oh, well, good start. If I actually lose on the basement seed, I'm going to be very disappointed. For those of you who don't know, the basement seed is, you just keep playing through the first two floors forever, or like the first, yeah, I don't know if it counts technically as two, like, I don't know how a lot of, like, the, like, I don't know what happens if you get Pandora's box. I don't know what that does with this seed. There's a lot of unknowns, at least for me. I'm not sure how a lot of things work with this, but basically you just play forever, and since it's the first couple levels, you it's almost impossible to lose. Since you know you just keep getting items and devil deals and stuff, and you keep getting perpetually better. I believe the devil deal chances go that you can't get one on the even numbered floors, but you can get one. I mean, you. Well, that's a good start. Jeez. You can, or you can't get them on odd numbered floors, and you can't get them on even numbered floors. Anyway. Also, just really quick, I meant to mention this earlier, but sorry if you hear any background noise or anything like that. We have the air conditioning running, and at least when I'm talking, and hopefully with game sounds and stuff, it's not too terribly loud, but yeah, I do apologize for that. It's not running at the moment, but yeah, this is just kind of, I don't know how much of this I'm going to commentate over, or how long I'm even going to play for this, because you could literally play this forever. Like, I don't know how long it would take for you to reasonably get every single item in the game. I don't even know if it's possible, really, unless you get chaos at some point. And if you get chaos, then it's just really annoying, of course. But, yeah, as of when I'm recording this, I only have, I only had one final exam this year. And, by the time this video goes up, I will be done with it. So I'll be completely done with high school by the time this video goes up. Which is kind of crazy. I started this, I think, in late 2014, so that would have been my sophomore year, I think. Yeah, I have a hard time counting, but yeah, it would have been my sophomore year. And the series has been going this long, and 100 episodes in, and you know, it's slowed down, of course, since starting, because I try to do other projects, and the content has dried up a little bit as of late, just because I've been having a hard time finding time, and Sacred Survival has been as well, to record more of Legendary. It's just literally done the same thing that it did the first time around, where it's gotten stuck at two episodes, which I don't know why it's always two, but yeah, we're just finding a hard time to find. We definitely will continue it and finish it eventually. We want to also do Suppress Sea of Flame, you know, do that as a live stream once again at some point. Not necessarily in the near future per se, but in the future, preferably like this year or so, but we haven't made any formal plans for that yet. Of course, we got Shell Shock going still. I still have a lot of backlog footage for that, and potentially us recording more in the future, because that's always a fun game to go back to, especially with how regularly it's updated. What is this again? Mark, that doesn't do me any good, actually. That's fine. Yeah, screw it. I'm just gonna go for it. Might as well. But, yeah, I want to... There's a lot of good stuff happening. Never mind, Mark II's is amazing. That's cool. That's an interesting synergy. I suspect I'm gonna be finding a lot of really interesting synergies in this run that I wouldn't have found otherwise. But there's a lot of really good stuff planned for this year. There's a lot of games coming out that I backed on Kickstarter. A lot of really good indies that I'm gonna be getting and playing. I've mentioned them all in the past, but La Milana 2 is one in particular that I'm really looking forward to. I'll be doing a live stream of that first. But then I think once I get a good handle of the game, I'll do a video series on it as well. There's Heartforth Alicia, which I think is just going to be a video series. There's Ukulele, which I haven't really decided on that yet. I can think of good points for either, so it might just end up being both. You know, I'll live stream it and then upload the live streams, maybe. There's Children of Morta, I believe, which... probably will just be live stream, most likely. Dark Souls 3, unfortunately, has fallen through the cracks due to the fact that I cannot run it without my computer crashing, which is very unfortunate. But, you know, in the future, like, more of a long-term thing, like, whoops. In the more distant future, I hope, when I get the ability to play it, I would definitely like to live stream, maybe when less people are streaming. Like, already, of course, the popularity has decreased after its initial release, but Yeah, that's unfortunately something I was really looking forward to that is most likely not going to see much much more coverage on my channels for a good long time. But yeah, it's just like I didn't really like plan, and like I planned on wanting to talk about it since it is a an interesting, you know, like how it's interesting how the two coincide, the 100th episode and me being basically finished completely with school for the moment. But I just wanted to say, I guess, thanks for everyone for, God, how do I have so much money, for sticking around for so long. You know, I had a giveaway running late recently. By the time this goes, yeah, this will be going up the day after the giveaway is finished. So also, if anybody entered that, be sure to check your emails and check the giveaway link. But yeah, it's just been really good experience overall on YouTube and Twitch. I definitely want to start live streaming more. I have been streaming a little bit more regularly as of late. I'm gonna take that, actually. I've been streaming a lot of the first level on it, just because I'm so excited for the second, and I've been really liking it. Also, as you can see, now that we got to the third floor, it's now basement 3 with a little question mark, and that will continue, I believe, to increment for forever, I think. I'm not actually sure. It might stop after like 10 or so, that it'll stop keeping track. Well, that's unfortunate. But yeah, Bold Heaven 2, I streamed for a bit. I don't know if I'll be streaming that a whole lot. God dang it, a whole lot more in the future, because you know, I did all the basic stuff, and like the only thing I have left now is to play through the game a whole bunch more, and you know, Mark 2 is a little dangerous. Ooh. How does this synergize? Does it? Oh, right. I remember now. That's cool. Yeah, I'm very okay with this. But, yeah, what was I saying? Oh, yeah, I also stream Rocket League a lot with some of my friends, and Left 4 Dead 2. I do Hearthstone and Pokemon TCG occasionally as well for you card game fans out there. And, yeah, that's pretty much most of what I wanted to talk about. Like, kind of a lot of this stuff was already brought up in the 1,000 subscriber special I did not too long ago. That is still the channel trailer, because I still have yet to make a channel trailer. But, still no devil deal. I guess I have been taking red heart damage on a lot of these floors, so I shouldn't be too surprised. That's at the end, okay. Let me see, small, that's fine with me. Puberty, okay. Pills have been pretty meh so far. I shouldn't have I keep forgetting that I have the dice. I haven't actually played as Isaac in a while, so I keep forgetting that I can, like, you know, re-roll things. But since I'm on the basement seat, I'm... what is this gonna do? Is that gonna do anything? Not really, I don't think. Okay. That's fine. I'd much rather take this anyway. I can't imagine it would do anything good at the very least. This video is kind of a special case. I don't suspect I'll be doing much else like this in the future. Just because I like to have videos where I always get stuff unlocked. You know, I do a challenge run, or I do a run that is definitely going to end in me getting a new unlock. But, you know, for the 100th video, I felt like it could be nice to mix it up a little bit. Afterbirth Plus is still coming this year, I think he's shooting for. There hasn't been any new news on that since my last video where I talked about it, but I'm very excited for that. I don't remember if I mentioned he's going to be he's taking suggestions for new challenge runs currently. He's looking to try to add up to around 5. So yeah, I'm very very excited for that. Any new content of this game is very exciting in my opinion, and yeah, I suspect by the time that comes out, I'll still be covering it. I want to keep doing videos on this game until I unlock everything, which is, you know, kind of a bit of a big undertaking, since that does mean I'll have to do, you know, every run on hard mode. I'll have to beat Mega Satan and the Hush with every character, all the challenges, all the greed mode with every, Also, I just realized because I don't have a face, now I just have a single eyeball, and that's a little unsettling. I'm gonna keep this, I think. Yeah, that's good. I'll take it. Damage up's okay with me, certainly. Oh, yeah, now I have, looks like I've gotten enough damage to get a little screen shake. No, that's fun. Oh, okay, here comes the AC. But, I had something else. I had somewhere else I was going with that, and I forgot. Oh, man, those explosions are nice. I just gotta be careful, because I know those are gonna hurt me. Oh my god, this is very destructive. I can't believe for a first item I got Epic Fetus. That's absolutely crazy. Oh, yeah, I'll take this. It's absolutely insane. But yeah, I'm really shooting for... I wanted to start live streaming this game at some point, too. So since not a lot of people stream it anymore. Like, a lot of live streamers that I like watching now, I found them through Isaac, but they don't really play it a whole lot anymore, which, I mean, makes sense. But, it just seems like something that... I don't know if still a lot of people do stream it. I don't really... I haven't really checked in a while. But, I have another save that I made, but kind of I want to wait to start streaming. I had this thought the same time when... Where was I going with that? Right. I had the same thought when I first started playing this game, is that I want to get an 100% save and then start live streaming it. But, yeah, I'm not sure, but I definitely want to 100% the game. I don't know if I'll continue to have fun with it the whole time, and I don't know if, you know, people will continue to still be watching it, even because it doesn't get the most views, certainly, out of all my series. It's not too bad. But, yeah, I really would like to keep playing this on my channel until it's done. Mostly because it'll help me to make sure that I keep playing it until it's done. Because, like, I stopped playing Epic Battle Fantasy 4, after I'd finished that series. And I still only need, like, one or two achievements left. And I just haven't gotten them yet. It's kind of unfortunate. But, what was this pill? Yes, please. It's definitely still something that I need to do. I want to do a video on it just because it's a difficult thing to do to be able to get all the damage you need for that. Yep, take that. Pretty sure. What's this one? Range up. That doesn't really help. Retrovision. Okay. But yeah, that way I can have just like my entire time with this game completely documented, which I think would be kind of cool. I will probably take that, but I'm gonna... Ooh, Brimstone. I recall that being a very fun synergy. I'm gonna take them both, I think. Let's see, what does this do? Yep. That is about what I thought it would do. This is gonna give damage. I'll just take it and reroll the shop, I think. Yeah. I'm gonna buy this. Because it'll give me 5 bombs. And then I'll reroll it. The ladder? Yeah, okay. That's acceptable. And now I'm gonna get out of here. Yeah, already it's literally impossible for me to lose, because as soon as I use my attack once, everything in the room is gonna die. This is fantastic. Yep, now it's on basement 5. Now it's just ellipses afterwards. Oh, this is so crazy. This is such a good synergy. I'm so excited to get a whole bunch of synergies that I've always wanted to get, but was never able to, just because of not being lucky enough to get the really good synergies. Give me this bomb already, jeez. This tiny hitbox, as I can already tell, is going to screw me up like it always has in the past. I don't know why I always go for really small sizes, but also now I just have the Jesus juice mouth. It's a little discomforting. Ow. Didn't even see what was happening there. But, yeah, it's crazy for me to think, though, that there are other people, like, other people who play this game, like, Northern Lion, of course, is the big example. I haven't checked lately, but they have to be in, like, up to, like, 600 or so by now. Missing page 2, I don't think I want that. Guppy's Tail, that's nice. Yeah, I'm pretty sure they're in, like, the 600s in their videos by now, at least. Like, I don't remember if that's an extreme in one direction or the other, but, it's just insane, like how much other people cover this game. Like, it makes sense that I can't, because I like to be able to play other stuff, and I don't have necessarily enough free time to be able to, you know, spend as much time on my channel as I'd like to, which is really something that that's unfortunate, because I really want to be able to put more time into these videos, you know, to spend more time recording them, spend more time editing them, so that everything's second, so that everything is, you know, really nice and high production, but I just don't have the time. I will for a little bit over summer, but even then, I'm going to college next year, so it's kind of a major change in, I don't think I want that. I definitely don't want that. It's just like a huge change in my life, and I'm worried, like, when I get to college, I'm not going to have any time at all to do this stuff. I'm hoping that at the very least, I'll still be able to live stream, because live streaming is, I'm coming to notice, is definitely easier than recording, because, like, I can decide that I want to play a game, and then I just boot it up, you know, boot up OBS, a couple programs, and then I'm live, and I just, you know, stream for however long I want, and then I stop, and that's it. I don't have to edit or render or, why do I keep doing that? or anything like that. So, at the very least, you know, if you enjoy, watching me play video games, I would definitely follow me over on Twitch, because that is, when the going gets rough, that's probably where I will be. It's a relatively infrequent uploading schedule that I have as is, but I'm really shooting for at least 2 or 3 videos a week whenever I can. All right, let's continue on here. This is a good run so far, to be sure. Basement 6 here. Yeah, they're not even putting any punctuation or anything at the end. They're just like, yeah, this is basement 6. You know the drill by now. We got moon card. Yeah. But yeah, I think that's really this again. That was the first time I remember seeing it, and I've already gotten it twice now. These guys, maybe get some nickels from you guys. Very nice. So much money. What is it? Oh, I got a hermit card. It's fine. I have plenty of consumables thanks to Sackhead. Sackhead's such a good item. Like, it's one of the most overpowered items in the game, I would say. It's just insane. No. I don't remember exactly what that does, but I will take it. In conclusion, I just want to say thanks, everybody, for some reason choosing my content. Choosing to watch me over, say, like, God dang it. I'm actually gonna die just because I keep taking damage because I keep forgetting how to play this video game. Choosing me over, like, Northern Lion and people who are, like, professionals at this. I want to get to that level at some point, but I certainly have plenty of time left in my life, preferably, or hopefully at least, to be able to get to that point. So, that's why I'm kind of happy I started doing YouTube and stuff early, is that it gives me a bit of a foundation to work on later on, when I have hopefully more time and a bit more ambition, maybe, to be able to, you know, really go with it. Blood clot, I'll probably end up taking that. I have a lot of rerolls, so I can certainly do better. Ooh, that. Honestly, with this build, that could be fun. I'm gonna go with it. Yeah, look at the. I just like how you can visually see the laser beams getting bigger. I don't know why I took that. If I rolled one, or if I didn't roll one, I was gonna roll the other, but I kind of forgot. Oh well. Plus, you get those nice dark red lasers, which are always nice. More pills. Range up, sure, it doesn't actually do anything. It makes you smaller. I might as well keep going with the small pills at this point. It's kind of. Ooh. Yeah, these are definitely both worth taking. Okay. That pill, I think, is a makes you smaller pill. I'll take it. Yep. I always love that. Okay. Let's continue on here. Yeah, I don't have any particular, like, time in mind, like how long I'm gonna go with this, but I'm just gonna keep going basically until I get bored. So, you know, we'll see how long that takes. I don't suspect, like, especially after considering how long some of these videos can be. I doubt it's even gonna be as long as some of the videos in the series in the past, certainly considering I've had like videos that have been close to an hour and 10 minutes. Like the one of the most recent ones I did, I think the Satan AFK run was, I think, from what I can remember, might be the longest in the series. I can't confirm that at the moment. But that sounds, from what I remember and what I noticed when I saw the time on that, it very well could be. So, yeah, I doubt it's gonna be even that long. Hopefully, I want to be able to show off some of the other seeds, especially because I don't even know what a lot of them do, so I'm kind of curious. But, like I said, I don't know. That's too risky of an item. It's also not even that good. Hell yeah, I'd like to have some fun here. I don't even know if that's gonna do a whole lot with this build, but it's worth the risk, honestly. Yeah, Brimstone doesn't synergize with a lot of secondary effects like that was a mistake. A lot of secondary effects like that, so I'm not expecting it to do much, but who knows? Maybe I'll get homing, or I can get that every once in a while. Apparently. Let me go ahead and ruin this block stay. Just have him. Oh, never mind, I forgot how that works. Blue map, yep. Blue heart, yep. And I'll check this card, because I have no reason not to. Emperor card, not really something that I need. I'll keep the world. Oh, why did it open? Did I get a... I can see forever pill at some point? Apparently I did. That probably would have been helpful, but that's not that important. My health is coming along nicely here. Another Emperor. Temperance machine. Might as well just blow that up. I only have one red heart. Never mind. I couldn't have done a whole lot with that. So yeah, I think that's all I wanted to do with any sort of remotely serious or important things that I felt the need to discuss. So yeah, we're just gonna be continuing on here. PJs, slash, I'll roll them both. Toothpicks. That's damage up. That's health up, though. Honestly, health up is kind of good, because I want to be able to take devil deals. Nah. Health ups are pretty common. That's just tears up. Never mind, that isn't actually going to help that much. I could have sworn that... I think the thing that tricks me up is that it makes your tears red, but it isn't actually a damage up. I forget that a lot. Yeah, well, that's fine. All the heart did was just straight. It's just a straight health up, so it wasn't especially valuable or important that I got it. So don't care with that. And yeah, the fruitcake is seemingly only a beneficial item, because sometimes I get like a creep pool, or I get the butt bomb effect there, or it creates a fire. So unlike normally when you get that item, it seems to only be an improvement. Not much of an improvement, granted, but you know, an upgrade's an upgrade, that's for sure. With upgrades like these, mom never stood a chance. Although we're never gonna be able to get to mom, so I guess that's kind of irrelevant. Is that the one that rerolls your build? No, that's... This is the use item. Yeah, the undefined. What does this do again? Well, that's fine, I guess. Okay. Like, I thought about that possibility, but I didn't actually expect it to happen, I'll be honest. So, well, I guess the D6 is gone. Not a huge loss. Considering it's, you know, a basement run, and it doesn't matter a whole lot, since I'm just gonna be getting most any item anyway, so that's fine. And I can take this with me, and it'll be kind of interesting, so that's fine. It's still an interesting item to hold on to. Ow. God dang it. But most in the future, I'm gonna try to wait to use it until I have at least gotten like the boss room and treasure rooms of the floors, though. Okay. Ooh, red key, or red card. Spades, yeah, sure. Keys are definitely no longer an issue. OK, Okay, got the other remote. Just about as crappy. Not even gonna bother. Okay. Oh yeah, shop is nice too. There's plenty of shop exclusive items that I would enjoy having. Oh. Alright. Ah, compass is nice. Dice shard. I'll definitely take that with me as well. Yeah. That could be some fun later on. Okay. So now, yeah, all I need is the regular treasure map, and then I'll have complete mapping, which is always good to have. That's fine. Easy peasy. Devil deal, maybe? No. Guess I'll take the speed up. Then I'll use this, see where it takes me. And, okay. I forget the rooms that can take you to. It's obviously treasure room, era room, or, I thought it could take you to secret rooms, but I think I might be thinking of a different item. Oh, I really don't remember, actually. I believe it's three different rooms, but I don't remember what the last one is. And I remember that's a really fun item to have when you're trying to do a breaking run, because, like, if you bring that item to the chest or the... usually the chest, because that's, you know, that's the fun place to go. If you take it there and, you know, you continually get lucky, you can just play the game indefinitely and just keep getting more sets of items, because you always get the guaranteed four items just from going into the chest at all. So, yeah, that kind of lead to some fun. Which is the main reason that I knew it could take me to the error room. I don't recall what the other rooms are. Okay. I'll be honest, the marked tiers is not all it's cracked up to be, because really I could do this anyway if I just, you know, kept holding down the button. But it's just, like, it forces you to keep attacking, which is kind of annoying when you, you know, don't want to be taking damage from your own bombs. Which, generally, you don't want to if you can help it. Unless you have, like, pyro or something. Yeah, I think, I don't know what I think, actually. I'm not sure where I was going with that. That happens a lot. I'm very forgetful. Like, a lot more forgetful than someone my age should be. We really had another floor where the... I can't see the map, that's kind of annoying. Okay. Some of these. I don't even need to bother picking... I don't really even need to pick up collectibles anymore. Did I get the treasure room yet? I don't remember. If I find the boss room, I'm probably just gonna go for it. Because I really want to get some fun devil items. Alright. Okay. Halo? Absolutely. Not that I'd have any reason to decline items at this point, because I don't have the D6, but... that's very nice. Excuse me, pardon me. Okay, got the shop. Everything I'm looking for. Yeah, I'll take that. And I'll also take this, and I'm just gonna automatically take any items that I find in shops at this point. Just because money certainly isn't an issue anymore. That was a very, very nice chest. Okay. Single card, what is it? Hermit? No thanks. I like this flashlight a lot. This is one of my more favorite kind of interesting items that they added in Afterbirth. Okay. Little horn again. I think he actually survived the first hit. That's impressive. I might regret not taking this health up now, so I'm just gonna go for it. Okay. Not anything that I want. I don't know if I even want to bother picking it up. I think just because the fact that I saw it means that it's out of the devil deal pool, but I don't remember how that works. Because since it's a space bar item, I think I would actually have to pick it up. But either way, that's fine. I don't feel like wasting two hearts just to pick it up and put it back down, so I'll pass. Having the red hearts could be kind of helpful anyway, so. I think, what floor are we on now? Are we really on floor 11 already? Jeez, okay. I think I'm going to switch and, I'm just gonna, mute my mic for a little bit here. And I will, jeez, what would anti-grav do with this? I'm gonna take it just to see what would happen. I don't know if it would do anything. No, it doesn't look like it. Okay. Let me just make sure. Yeah, okay. That's what I figured. That's fine. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go ahead and mute my mic, and I'll just, I'll switch it back on if anything interesting happens, or if, like, if I get a neat synergy or anything like that. So, yeah, I will see you guys then. Until then, just, enjoy the unadulterated mayhem that this build is. I didn't think this would actually do anything, getting monsters lung, but, it kind of goes crazy. And depending on how many, because it's a random amount of shots, so, but if you get upwards of, like, 5 or so, it starts to lag the game. So, this is looking to be a run that will probably end when the game crashes, if I had to guess. That's how the last one I did of this, that's, I believe, the time when I did the game did actually crash when I did that video of the, oh my god, of like the crashing run where like it just like created an infinite amount of explosions that just eventually overloaded the game. I feel like that's probably what's gonna happen. Ooh, chaos card. It's kind of fun, not really helpful, but I'll take it. I'll just finish up this floor and then I'll whoops, I didn't actually want that. Yeah, the blue cap would have been maybe kind of nice there, but that's fine. Okay. I'll take Horde Babylon. Oh, wait, I could fly. Okay. Yeah, I'll see you guys when something else interesting happens. Well, now that we have the D20, I think now we should really be able to, with the D20 and the with Sackhead, this is pretty much instant breaking, like, no matter where you use it. As long as, like, I'm even gonna try to do it right here, because the fact that coins turn into bags and bags can give batteries, let's give it a quick test run here. So I'm gonna pick these up. Already some batteries, of course. I'm not gonna take them though, I'm gonna roll them. Couple chests, couple bags, a bunch of bags. If I get one battery, yeah, this is pretty much already, this is already over. This is, oh man. Oh, golly. Yeah, this, credit card, okay. I will take that. I'm actually gonna go ahead and drop that out here, because that's, quite useful. Yeah, I'll leave both of those there, actually. And let's go ahead, well, let me open up this bag first. Yeah, looks good. Yeah, this is already over. There's no doubt about that. I'm gonna continue to take the, makes you small pills until I do not have a sprite anymore. That's the goal here. I'm pretty much already there, so it's not going to be particularly difficult to achieve that. What is this? Resistance? I don't really care. Just contact me. Let's get rid of that. Judgment? I will go ahead and use that in here, though. Gold bomb? I'll pick that up. Just cuz. Sure. Listen to my little noises. That's so cute. Give me something, why don't you? Well, I mean, that is something. Oh, and also, yeah, because I have the habit, I'm also going to continue to... Yeah, this is, oh, why am I not taking... Okay. Yeah, every once in a while, I just kind of stop taking damage. I think that's the scapular, but, it's more of a guess than anything. I believe that's what's doing that, but... Make me smaller, please. Come on, give me something. Being a real butt right now. There we go. Cursed eye. I'm gonna try to hold on picking up any pedestal items for the moment. Oh dear. I'm also gonna go ahead and pick up any hearts that are in here, just to be sure. Ooh, almost picked it up. Two hearts, I'll just go ahead and use that. There we go. Card, double card. Are there any useful cards in here? Chariot's okay. I'll go with that. And, oh, there's a bunch of runes, let me check those quick. I'll take a soul heart. And destruction. Okay. Roll again. Ooh, growth hormones is really good. I think that might give me spun. No, I think I still need one more, actually. Fantastic. This is, yeah, if you ever get the D20 and Sackhead, it's... it would probably be harder to not break the game than it would be to break it. Because it's, it literally becomes effortless. As long as you get a bag, when you roll the D20, you get a bag in it that has a battery in it, which makes it a lot more likely, because otherwise you would have hoped to just get a battery by itself. But the bags have a very high chance of giving batteries, as you can see there. So it's kind of crazy. Now the judgment, where did the judgy go? No, this is gotta be this one. There we go. Another health one, that's fine with me. This guy's gonna give some nice items. A little bit difficult to use considering my small size. Look at that tiny little shield I have. It's like actual pixels. Like, you can see how pixelated this character is. This is insane. I sound like a little mouse. It's so cute. Okay, safety pin. What is this? Alright, I'll keep that, sure. Oh my goodness. This is, yeah. Yeah. This is pretty much over. Like, I don't know if I want to pick up items, or if I want to... There we go, that's what I've been waiting for. Plethora rune. I think I'm going to get this plethora rune out of here. See if there's anything else useful in here. Not really. This I definitely want. I'm gonna... Wait, I picked up... Oh, Jera's really good too, though. Never mind. Yeah, let me drop this one off, too. I think I'll probably bring Jera in with me next time I come through here. Where did... It's gotta be, it's, yeah, okay. So I'm gonna get Perthro out of here, and I'm gonna bring Jarrah in, I think. And next time I roll, I think I will Perthro before I open anything up, so that way if there's any, if there's a decent amount of gold chests, at least I will. And then I'll have a good chance of doubling any amount of pedestal items I would have gotten. Oh, I need to be, try to be careful to not pick up any of those items. Because I'm now to a point where, now that I have this Perthro rune, I have a damn good reason to not pick up these items until I get something, some nice stuff. Okay, I think this is a couple unopened bags, but it's not gonna make a huge difference if I don't pick them up, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Okay. Yeah, let me just go ahead and Jarrah this. Oh dear. Ooh, treasure map. Quotable slots. A bunch of bomb items. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I think this is around when I just kind of start running around and picking up whatever I get. I'm just gonna, yeah. Oh, that was actually spun, okay. Yeah, I've officially lost that, that Yarrow rune as well. Oh, wait, no, that's right, I took it out of the room. I remember now. What is this? Oh, right, another Bacana, that makes sense. Okay. Yeah, I'll probably pick up anything that isn't a spacebar item. I mean, I'll pick up everything, but, I think I will, I mean, I'll just take whatever the game gives me if it's not a spacebar item. Just because, you know, I'm looking to get every item in the game anyway. No, that's, I'm probably not going to play for that long, but, this is a little nuts. Yeah, I don't even, oh, let me get Cursed Eye. How did I not pick that up yet? There we go. I don't know what that's even going to do. I almost just, trying to use my weapon in here would be, or my tears in here would be a terrible decision. There's a lot of cards, oh my goodness. I actually used the judgment, cool, that's what I wanted to do. At this point, I just have to estimate where I am based on where the flies are. Another pedestal item, or another spacebar item even, that's very nice. Okay, that'll be another thing to Perthro later on. Roll it. Oh dear, ooh, Trinity Shield. Very nice. I'm just gonna go ahead and blow that up the old-fashioned way. I'm surprised it hasn't started doing the gyrating thing yet, but, oh, there we go, now it's starting, okay. Yeah, it's definitely gonna do that this roll. Like, before I even roll it another time, because after I open up all these chests and bags, yeah. Yeah, rip, video quality. That's a thing of the past now. Oh, dear. Another Eternal Heart. Death Shard? I'm just gonna use that quick, yeah. Might as well. Because I figured out that I was never gonna find that thing again, so. What even happened that would have led to me getting teleported here? I can't even think of what that could have been. Oh, well. Give me the box. And there we go. A little delayed. Yeah, the lag from these tears or these lasers a little much. What is this? Magician, sure. Alright, I'm back. Oh my goodness. I love this. This is so good. Did I get, there we go, butt bombs. Oh, I see an I think that's Incubus up here. Oh no, that was Succubus, okay. Can I remember which is which? This is so good. I see Dead Baby's Soul there. I see the Faded Pyro. Oh, I see regular Pyro. I'm looking for Pyromaniac, preferably. But, oh, stop moving. That's interesting. Oh, I got the bean somehow. Very interesting. Another chest here. More stuff. Okay. Alright. Is there anything? What's this card? Health up, pill, sure, I'll use it. Alright. Roll it. Not a whole lot of chests this time, actually, doesn't look like. Especially not gold chests, but that's okay. Yeah, now we're really done here. This is We're never gonna see the end of this. Now, if there's pageant boy, I'd like to pick it up. Where am I? I can barely even see where the flies are anymore. This is such a mess. Oh my god. Is it even possible to pick up items in this room anymore? I'm not even sure, to be honest. Oh, I got cursed at the tower? Oh dear. Oh well, with sad bombs and brimstone, I don't know if that synergizes with that, but could be kind of fun. Can we just get pageant boy? Whatever. I can pick it up later. There's a locked chest up there. Oh god. I forgot what happens when I use my own bombs. That happens. Oh dear. Book of Sin? What do I get? Oh, I picked up the broken remote. Okay. Ooh. Oh, these are both nice, honestly. Hell yeah. I'll take homing brimstone laser bombs. Yeah, now we're talking. Nice purple color. That's what I was really hoping for. Oh, and the moving slowed down a bit. That's nice. Okay, pick this up. And pick this up. And then we roll it. There we go. That's a good looking amount of gold chest there. Another eternal heart. Yeah, my red hearts are gonna be full in probably one or two more rolls at most. Whoops. It's fine. Okay, I see Necronomicon. I see Book of Secrets. Plenty of pedestal items that can reroll at a later point. No problem there. I took damage and then, oh no, Curse of the Tower does actually do that, okay. If anything crashes the game at this point, I suspect it would be that. Okay, now I need to pick up D20 again. There we go. A little bit trickier than you would think. Guppy's Paw, okay. Certainly isn't something to want, but still another pedestal item's nice, especially since I basically can't identify pedestal items anymore. I don't even see what, like, I keep picking up the bean, and I just picked up Guppy's Paw, and I have no idea where either of those are. I see the three books. Oh, there's the paw, there's the bean. Okay, never mind, I see them all now. Alright, let's go again. That moment of relief between rollings is so nice. Hierophant card. Pandora's box, I'd like to get 20 back, there we go. I want to make sure I keep track of this thing. What an experience this is. God dang it. What an experience. This is about everything that I dreamt it would be. What is that? What is that oh, Trinity Shield. Okay, I was confused what that massive, like, brown tooth-looking thing behind me was. Also, I lied. This is going to be a much longer video than any that I've done in the past, just because I wasn't expecting to get the D20, let alone this early. Okay, if I just keep picking things up... Hey, we actually got it down to a reasonable level. Look at that. That's quite nice. What is this? Okay. Regular beggar. Not sure why I was getting so many devil beggars there for a while. That was weird. Alright, give me something here. Well, that's something, but... Meh. Pedestal item, preferably. That's interesting. I guess because I hadn't picked it up yet, so it didn't think that I had it entered yet. That's fine. No, makes no difference when I roll them, so. As long as I pick everything up, yeah, okay. I think I'm good to go. Yeah, I'm good to roll whenever I want now, I think. I got Pandora. Oh, there's Guppy here. Or Gimpy, I mean. Oh, it's Champion Spell, too. I'll gladly take a Champion Spell. There's a gold heart. Okay. Ready to go. Ooh. It's looking good this time around. That's for sure. Yep. I think I'm gonna give this a few more rolls, I think, and then I'll come back when I'm ready to roll everything with the plethora room. So yeah, I'll see you guys in a bit. Actually, since it has presented itself to me, there's a dice shard right around where I'm standing, so I'm just gonna use that. And, we'll see what that does. Okay, so now we have a Book of Rev, Glitter Bombs, Guardian Angel, Sticky Bomb. Hello again. Sticky Bombs, Contract from Below, Synth Oil, some good stuff, yeah. We'll probably pick up most of this once the chaos dies down a bit. Might as well use that too. Actually, yeah, there's not much of a point. Well, actually, it can help get rid of the all the batteries in here, so I'm actually gonna go for that. It'll help clear out some of the items. I'd like to be able to stop this shaking so that I can actually pick up the items in that room if I can. Just gotta watch out that I don't actually accidentally pick up the D20, because then I'm just gonna roll everything again. Oh, hello. This is, yeah, it didn't help a whole lot. That's fine. It should... It has to stop eventually. I'm just gonna keep doing whatever in this room for a little while. This is thoroughly enjoyable, so... I'll probably go at least one or two more rolls, and then, I'll use the plethora rune at the very end just to wrap it up, so... I'll see you guys... Wait, there's another dice shard. Well, there's not much to roll at this point. There's, like, one pedestal item, or one spacebar item. Also, I just noticed that I just got breakfast, and I don't know if that means that we exhausted an item pool or something, but, it might be signifying something, at the very least, because, you know how it goes with breakfast. I just noticed that Abaddon is in the room, and actually, if I were to pick up Abaddon, I would just die, unless they change that at some point. Last I checked, if you have full red hearts and you pick up Abaddon, you die, because it gives you the black hearts at the same time as it takes your red hearts away, so you just end up with zero hearts and you're just dead. So I suppose that adds a little bit of risk to it, and would, you know, if I pick that up, well, then I guess that's the end of the run, so... yeah, just thought I would mention that, because that's, kind of worth mentioning, that, I'll be generally trying to avoid that, if I can. Okay, so apparently I picked up a dead cat somewhere in that mess, so Abaddon will no longer be lethal. So, that's nice. I'll actually go ahead and try to pick it up then in that case. Just for fun. Just to make sure that I get it. And yeah, I'm definitely noticing a large influx of breakfasts. So, with the combination of the Chaos card and all this rerolling, we've definitely exhausted an item pool somewhere along the way. Oh, did I get it? Yeah, I got it, okay. I would guess maybe the library pool is very potentially drained, because we have been picking up and getting a lot of the books. Just a guess, though. Yeah, we got a lot going on here, so. Get back up here. It's a little baggy there. It's not really something I want to get. Caffeine pill? Okay. Yeah, I'll see you guys when, yeah, I don't even know what to say anymore. The stars. So I think I am ready to move on here. At least for a bit. I'm just about done here in general, but I'm just gonna leave and hopefully that that stops doing what it's doing. It's a bit dangerous bringing this thing in, though. That's the only thing. Let me see about bringing something less valuable in, at least at first, because I want to make sure that it's relatively calm, which it isn't. Let me, yeah, okay. It's still very unstable. Let me see if I can find where those pinking shoes go. Pick those up and see if I can, I'm gonna start using cards, too. That'll certainly help. Just anything that I could do to get things off of the ground. But that didn't actually help, but using the lover's pill, or the lover's card actually just made it worse. I just used the tower card. That was an also poor choice. Everything's fine. Hangman's fine. Two diamonds is fine. Devil's fine. Okay. Keep using cards. Keep using cards. Emergency contact definitely sounded, different. Whoops. Well, leaving and coming back in sometimes helps too, so. Oh, god dang it. Let me go back to using pinking shears. There's a few batteries around at least. Oh, I just want the madness to stop. Okay. Okay, this is better. Okay, so I'm going to get the wig. I'm going to get the big beautiful fly. Pick up Isaac's heart, sure, why not? Why not? Holy mantle. I thought I already got a pentagram, so I'm actually gonna pass on that, and I'm also gonna pass on any of these health up items. Okay, I think. Oh, there's a liver over there. Yeah, that's fine, I don't need health up. Looking for Perthro. Okay, where'd it go? Oh, just had it. Keep losing it. Come on. Ah, that's the fool. It's fine. Perthro. There we go. Okay, screw. Yeah, definitely even more, breakfast. Take that. Glowing hourglass. I don't think I can do a whole lot with that. Take this. Okay, I really want to crash the game now, I'll be honest. I'm not sure what I can do to help that, but I mean, I have ridiculous bombs. Let's see what happens just when I should do this. Oh, yeah, that was just like 3 shots, and that already got pretty close, especially with glitter bombs. Let's just kind of go to town here. Especially since I have the golden bomb, I'm just gonna keep doing a lot of this. This game is resilient, though, I'll give it that. It's not gonna be easy to crash it. No doubt about that. Yeah, it's gonna be very tricky, no doubt about it. Oh, I thought I just did it for a second, but the game really didn't like transitioning during that with all those explosions on screen, though, that's for sure. This is so beautiful. It really is. This is fantastic. Just crash already. What more can I get that would help this crash? Yeah, as you can see, at this point I can just fly through the floors in less than a minute each. Like there's nothing to it anymore. It's just over. But I think that's gonna just about do it. I don't think waiting for me to be able to crash the game is necessarily a smart idea, because it pretty rarely happens. Like, I would need to have spent a lot more time breaking than I did if I want to be able to crash it, I would say. Oh boy, breakfast. My favorite Devil Deal item. So yeah, thanks again everybody for watching and sticking with me. Been a lot of fun getting up to 100, and here's to 100 more, I suppose. It's pretty standard thing to say, but I could certainly see it happening. Yeah, please like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. Stay tuned for more giveaways in the future. There's going to be at least two more Pokemon ones this year, because there's still more more GameStop events. I'm always looking to do more giveaways. I am about to, or maybe have already hit 200 followers on Twitch. So once that happens, or once I get around to making the video for that, I will be doing a like a 12-hour live stream, which I haven't done ever. I've never streamed for that long. Breakfast everywhere. Yeah, 12. I don't think I could muster a 24-hour live stream, I'll be honest, unless I have a lot of company and, you know, people around to help with that. So I wouldn't bet on a 24-hour, but yeah, probably a 12-hour live stream, maybe with a giveaway or two thrown in, because I do still have a lot of old game codes that that I have to give away for a whole bunch of different games that I got from, like, spare keys from Humble Bundles and stuff like that. But, yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys later. Also, really quick, something I didn't know, actually, that I guess they added this in Afterbirth, but you see the My Stuff thing? You can scroll this, actually, and you can just kind of see just how many items I have. Oh, it still says narrow, but I can't scroll anymore that way. Yeah, quite a few. Yeah, I did not know you could scroll this. That's really cool. But, yeah, I'll see you guys later.